good at taking no action, Counselor.
Amen.
45, advanced ambulance service. Ms. Mills, Mr. Boff?
Yes, I'll go ahead. A while back, there were sort of exceptional process made for providing additional funding for advanced ambulance service. The unusual nature of it was, in my opinion, that it was out of the budget cycle. It was a request, I think, from the owner. Chief, I'm going to speak for you. Correct me, of course. I don't think the fire chief was in support of at least some of the conversation that went on at the time. And so I think Cindy and I had talked, and we were interested in bringing up the possibility of revisiting this and seeing if it should be brought to bid so that it might save John some money.
I have a few other things that I felt like, in light of recent events, that I needed. I felt like the public needed to hear us have a conversation. I felt like that it. I've had people reach out to me, mothers in particular, on Facebook, asking me what's going on, what happened, and I have, you know, said very little that I didn't know. But I would like to have some type of certitude to be able to go back and you know, just to reassure that the public is, that all is well and that there's safety there. Also, in speaking on that, that there is no risk of liability to the county in relation to what happened in the past and in going forward, if the county has any liability in that as well.
And you had to do it in a public forum instead of just calling the attorney?
You don't think the public should hear us talk about it?
But you could have called Kendra, or they can't answer.
Let me offer up this, first of all, just from this perspective, and I know that everybody is trying to be as reasonable and discriminating as they can be in this discussion, and I first of all, applaud that and want us to continue with that. So let me just say this. With respect to any issues with respect to service or service interruption or service impact, I'm going to yield to the fire chief. So in other words, to the extent we want to address service, we can address that. To the extent we're talking about potential liabilities, I will say this and address the board this way. I am not aware of any potential liabilities with respect to any of the circumstances that have occurred either recently or candidly even further back than recently. My understanding is that with respect to interaction with patients or individuals being transported, there has been no issue raised with respect to those events. And so I want to leave that right there and kind of move on to the next issue. To the extent we're talking about service issues generally, is the service desirable? Is it prompt? Is it efficient? Is it the best bang for the dollar for the county? I would yield to the fire chief on that and see and let him address the board. But with respect to any recent events, I'd say that I appreciate it being raised. Obviously, the county's thinking about it, not aware of any liabilities based upon it, and I think that perhaps we should focus the debate, if agreeable, on perhaps just the nuts and bolts of service being provided.
Okay. Chief, do you have any to add to that about the service of the ambulance service, or are you satisfied, the county satisfied?
Mr. Chairman, the contract calls for advanced ambulance to arrive on the scene of a presumptive emergency. Give me an example. Shortness of breath, chest pains, head injury, the like. To arrive on the scene of a presumptive emergency within 8 minutes, 90% of the time, provable to the ambulance contract administrator, Captain Hamilton, monthly. They have met that standard every month. Captain Hamilton, did I just make a correct statement?
Yes, sir.
Do you feel like our charges are equal to other counties or sitting around us?
Mr. Chairman, I've not done a comparative analysis, but at the will of the board, I can bring you that.
Well, Ken, maybe you could tell a little bit about the contract. It can be
Yeah, the contract that is in place right now has the standard language that is required by law with respect to multi-year county government contracts. Right now, the contract anticipates, I believe it would be fair to say the contract anticipates at least through a 2017 date. At least that's the way there is a subsidy we built into the last version of the contract, and at least anticipates that subsidy through 2017. But what the contract does provide is, to the extent that the Board of Commissioners wishes to terminate the contract, that the standard language is in there, and that is that we would have to provide 30 days advance written notice of non-renewal prior to the end of the upcoming calendar. So, you know, my take on this agreement is, absent a breach, which is not what I'm hearing here, that it would need to provide notice at least 30 days prior to the end of the year, and then the contract would end at December 31st of the then existing calendar year, and that's going to be the same for every subsequent calendar year.
So
and when would you go out to bid? I mean, when would you?
Well, I mean, I would want to defer to Don on that, but to the extent that we're talking about taking action to change our ambulance service provider, I don't expect that is something that is done quickly. I expect that's something that would be need some advance time, because you're going to have a seamless handoff.
And this person, an advanced ambulance, could put a bid in, and if they come back the best, I mean, they could be awarded it back. There's nothing stopping if they're competitive.
Yes.
There would be nothing to prohibit them being able to get the contract back.
No, ma'am.
I concur with Commissioner Boff in the fact that I wasn't on the board then. I did attend the meeting that Chief Bowman spoke against the raise, and that Donna spoke against the raise, and then I was also at a meeting when it was coming up for bid, and instead of letting it come up to bid, it was pushed 5 years more out. Instead of letting it come to bid, I have not seen that done again for any company since I've been on the board. I didn't see it happen in that year that I was watching meetings before I came on the board. I don't know that it best, and that's not saying anything against advanced ambulance. I just don't know that that serves the citizens of Forsyth County fairly to not go out to bid, to not make sure. I don't know what the fear is. I don't know what the fear of a board would be to let it go back out to bid, and if it's the right thing, if it works, then you'll get it back. I don't know what the fear of commissioners would be to allow that to happen.
Let me ask Pat one question. How hard is it?
Don.
I'm sorry. Yeah, how hard is it to put something like this out for bids?
This bid usually is out at a minimum for 4 months. It takes about a 4 month term at a minimum.
Yeah, so it's not something you do ever.
No, that's why it's usually a multi-year one, because it's an investment of equipment from the service provider that we make them put in. So that's why it's usually a minimum five-year contract. But it takes time for the people to respond and for us to get this out.
So it's not unusual to have a five-year contract.
No,
most counties.
And this one initially was a five-year contract.
Mm-hmm. But it was extended 5 years at the end of already.
May I share some history? Chief, I have permission to address Chief Shivers.
Chief Shivers, come forward.
Yes, sir.
The previous discussion, sir, that I've had concerning the ambulance service when I first came on the Board of Commissioners, I had a conversation with you in reference to how we came about using advanced services, and there was an ambulance service prior to us. Counselor, I guess I shouldn't mention that name of that company?
Or is it? You can mention the name of that company.
Actually, I believe it was Rural Metro, am I correct?
That's correct, yes, sir.
And at the time, Rural Metro was doing our contract. What was the level of service, and was there any issues with them always finding their ambulances in Fulton County instead of servicing our citizens?
It was less than desirable.
And that was a problematic, because ambulances are used for life-saving.
Of course.
And what year was that?
It was prior to 2008, so 2007, back 5 years.
Correct. And then when the bids came out in 2008, advanced ambulance came in $850,000. Priority came in at $1.189 million. Rural Metro came in at $842,000. But they weren't here doing the services that we were paying for.
That's correct, sir.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
And for that reason of life-saving, it bothers me tremendously to put out the bid, and we know we have an ambulance company now that fell within the lowest bids, that remains within that price range and only going up with inflation, and has produced a service that meets their contracts every single month.
They get a 3% inflation every year.
And
then you try to give them a 7% on top of that, that would have extended, it would have made over the life of their contract $350,000 more. That's not inflation. That goes way beyond inflation.
But we didn't.
No, we did, but it wasn't because he didn't want to.
But we gave it just 3%.
Ma'am, they were utilizing a seventh ambulance we weren't paying for.
And we paid, we did that too.
They were asking for some reimbursements for it.
And I've got no problem with that.
And they have been doing it for years, asking for some kind of compensation for back services they provide us, although we didn't have to, but they've been so good to the county and the people here. I, for one, felt that it was somewhat reasonable. I wasn't overpaying them. They were not getting back what they felt they produced in service for that time frame. They asked for a fraction of the money. And after doing a study, we found out we needed the seventh ambulance. And then back in 2008, there was a preliminary request asking for a seventh ambulance. And those calls increased by 30% over the next 3 years, and that's why they were having to give us, because they had a contract to meet deadlines of time frame of 8 minutes. They felt it necessary to put that in there at their expense for that time to meet that contract, and they weren't being compensated for it. Until this board was able to afford a seventh ambulance, they were eating it for years.
Yeah, but now don't we have to compensate them some?
Now we do for seventh ambulance, now that we have it.
But I mean, if we terminate the contract early, we have to compensate them even more.
Even more.
Do you not feel that if they are that competent, do you not have confidence that they, if they are that competent and doing that good of a job, they might not, they will get the contract back?
Well, probably. I know.
I mean, I'm told by people way up at Northside Hospital that there's other companies out there that would love a chance to bid.
I believe that. I do.
I mean, and that have excellent professional service. But we don't know. And do you not think that Ms. Cucarola is confident that she can look at the bids?
Sure she can.
And be able to see? So why are we doubting that she can't do her job?
Let me assure that when Vance England came with their bid last time, they were about 35% lower than the rural metro that was in here.
So,
but what happens, Ms. Mills, if they all come back in at their higher rate of the bids, and this time Vance England comes back in and says, you know what, I'm going to cut them up in my bid because I was 33% lower than them last time. I'm going to come back up 20%, and what happens if we get stuck paying an extra $250,000 a year more than we do now?
Well, we haven't had any complaints, and I agree with you.
We haven't had any complaints. And this is about life-saving. This is not about whether it's $10 more or not. This is life-saving stuff, and they perform to the level that meets what our fire chief that manages them asks for and within their contract. If they were doing things bad, I get it. Just like Rural Metro, they went up for bid because Rural Metro was not performing at that level.
That's a look at complaints. Any other discussion at this moment? Do you want to make a motion anyway on this? If I want to make a motion or just up for discussion at this moment?
I mean, how soon do we need a motion made to be able to put it out to bid?
What was the annual renewal of the last contract?
2000.
The last renewal would have clicked over, ended December 31st of 2013. We're in the middle of a new year, calendar year term right now.
Every year's renewal.
So we got three more years.
You can't do it.
Three more years in this 5-year contract.
But there's also a buyout. I mean, we had to do some kind of a buyout, did we not, on this one?
That was discussed, but that never made it into the
agreement.
What if the chief told them to bring back the information on some other, what they charged?
Right, you know, we could decide by the end.
Yeah, well, I'm going to do that.
What he charged?
Well, he said he could do some information, didn't you, chief?
Well, the jurisdictions are paying for private services.
Can I clarify what the board's directing me to do, Mr. Chairman?
We haven't said asked you yet, but what would you like to do?
Can I comment on one thing? I know Donna mentioned 4 months. I've got to believe that the process will take at least that long. Once you get this on the streets, you get the bids in and process, and that company, whoever it is, regardless of who it is, would need some time to
ramp up.
And I don't think it would be wise to consider this if you move forward with putting this out for bid too much later in the year.
Yeah.
If you're serious about this,
it
you probably need
now.
To move on it pretty quickly.
It would be the latest, I would say.
And Mr. Chairman, if you're wanting to get a comparative analysis, what adds to the difficulty is many of our contiguous counties around, the fire department provides the transport.
Oh, okay.
Cherokee does.
Cherokee and Hall.
That would be hard.
Yeah, and I know that we discussed that one time, it's a lot more money than us hiring up on.
Don, is there a kind of a hybrid of that where we could go out and get some information from other companies to bring something back to the board without going out full blown bid?
We could do like a request for information and just ask for, it depends on what information you're trying to find out. I could do a request for information from other jurisdictions, we'd have to be even all within Georgia. Or if you're going to ask for, and it would be a request for proposal for this type of service, because we definitely would want to look at other things besides the price. That would be very hard to do. Because it would cost, it would lay people's hands open.
Yes.
And it would cost them money to provide that service.
But right now, we're satisfied with our service, correct, Chief Bowman?
That's a correct statement, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Chief Bowman.
Do you have a motion?
So do you.
Or do you want to think about it?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, Jim, you want to make the motion and if it does, it fails.
I'll wait at this point.
All right, I guess we'll gather more information and see. I'll talk to some people in hospital and see some of their ambulance services.
You're asking nothing from staff at this point,
staff or chief at this point.
Thank you.
Thank you, Chief.
Thank you, Chief. Good day,
sir. Gentlemen.
Item 26, replacement counselor, conflict of interest.
Counselor?
This is happening more and more.
You can just replace it altogether.
Did you hear about that?
Is that a good idea?
Careful.
I'm not gonna get out of here.
Add that to the next one.
Hey, I'll tell you.
Thank you, Chief. I'm obsessed with that.
This will be, I hope, really very, very quick. We have received a lawsuit